Good morning. This is Sanjay Vish, Associate Professor, Gyanendra Singh Institute of Pharmacy, Dehradun. So today we'll be discussing about a small topic that is Woodward Fisher rule. So in 1945, scientist Robert Burns Woodward gave some rules for correlating wavelength and structure. After that, 1959, Louis Frederick Fisher modified these rules with more experiment data, and both the rules combinedly are called as Woodward-Fisher rule. They are given in this using these rules, we can find out the lambda max, that is maximum wavelength at which a compound absorbs the UV radiations. So using these rules, we can calculate lambda max of any compound or any given structure. So lambda max, they are given the formula lambda max is equal to summation of base values of the cyclic rings which are present in the structure, base values plus the summation of the substituents like double bond, triple bond, these are the other type of substituents which are present, their values, their absorption value is also added, and then other contributions like halogen groups. So these type of the wavelength, the absorption of all these together called as lambda max for the particular compound. So we can see some structures, like this is called as homo-annular diene. Homo-annular diene is like when there are two double bonds present in a single ring, cyclic ring. Then hetero-annular diene. Hetero-annular diene is when two double bonds are present in a conjugation in two adjacent rings. Then we come to the exocyclic double bond. Exocyclic means, exo means anything which is outside the cell or any structure. So exocyclic double bond means this one, that is, which is present outside the first ring. Suppose it is A, it is B. So when this double bond is present outside this cyclic ring, it is called as exocyclic double bond. Then double bond extended conjugation. Like here, these two double bond in a particular ring is in conjugation, and then again one double bond is present in the next ring, which is again in the conjugation of the double bond present in the first ring. So this is called as double bond extended conjugation. For these structures, some parent values, or we can say base values, are given by these scientists. Like for acyclic conjugated diene, acyclic means when the structure is not cyclic. So acyclic conjugated diene, if it is present in the structure, or there is heteroannular diene present in the structure, will add the base value as 215 nanometers. Similarly, for the homoannular diene, we have the value 253 nanometers. For acyclic triene, like this, we have the base value 245 nanometers. Now coming to the substituents or other contributions. So increments, like if there is alkyl group present in the structure, for each alkyl substitute we will add 5 nanometers. Similarly, for exocyclic double bond, we add 5 nanometers. And for double bond extended conjugation, we add 30 nanometers to the base value. Now we'll take a simple example. Suppose we have a structure. Your base value will be 215 30 nanometers. So this is how we can calculate the lambda mesh of any given structure by using Woodward-Fisher.